Hi, my name is Isabelle Coenen, and I will be presenting our recently published paper titled Reduced Type 1 Interferon by Plasmacytoid Dendritic Cells and Asthma in School-Aged Children. So the purpose of our study was to evaluate the virus response of plasmacytoid dendritic cells in vitro in children with asthma. We used a cohort of 71 children who had regular recordings of viral swabs and respiratory events in their first 2 years of life. Once these children reached 7 years old, they were then again evaluated for allergies and asthma diagnoses, and blood samples were taken for analysis. Plasmacytoid dendritic cells were stimulated in vitro with R848, which is a virus analogue, and the response was analysed using flow cytometry, RNA sequencing, and cytokine analysis. From flow cytometry, we identified two plasmacytoid response clusters to R848 stimulation, one being an interferon high response cluster and the other one being an interferon low response cluster. There was an increased proportion of children with asthma that had an interferon low plasmacytoid dendritic cell response to R848 stimulation. And furthermore, this interferon low response was also associated with increased ATP. RNA sequencing analysis also identified an interferon signaling network, which was also upregulated in the interferon high plasmacytoid dendritic cell response cluster. We also pre-incubated plasmacytoid dendritic cells with anti-IgE prior to R848 stimulation and found through flow cytometry that the total proportion of activated plasmacytoid dendritic cells were reduced compared to stimulation with R848 alone. Furthermore, RNA sequencing analysis also identified a reduction in the gene LILRA4 from pre-incubation with anti-IgE. And this gene has been implicated in the inhibition of interferon alpha production in PDCs. So overall, our study suggests that IgE can affect interferon production in children with asthma. However, there could also be other factors that can also contribute to this altered response. And with that, I would like to thank all of my co-authors for their contributions to this study, and thank you guys for listening.